Gentlemen, welcome to the post-lunch session, a masterclass on design thinking by KPMG India. It's my pleasure to invite Ajay Agarwal, design thinking practice lead KPMG India, and Rohit Kaul, product designer KPMG India, to start the session.
I can't see the people at the back, last row. The guy on the cell phone, yeah, great. Oh, great. Good. So, good afternoon, everyone. Hi, I am Ajay Agarwal. He introduced me as the design thinking practice lead at KPMG. Let me introduce myself. I am Ajay Agarwal once again, a Haryanvi by origin, an entrepreneur by heart, and a consultant by choice. Teen qualities, got three qualities. Okay, done. So, I know it's a post-lunch session, and some of you are here to avoid the outside heat. So, I will create some heat for you inside also. Right? So all of you stand up, please, before we start our session. All of you stand up. Oh, great. Choose a partner for yourself. Quickly, choose a partner for yourself. So people are now searching. Gone. Oh, one guy is exit. One of our customers is gone. Yeah? Okay, great. Cool. So choose a partner, guys. Why is he standing so far? Please come along. Okay, cool. So decide who's person A and person B, fast. Between the partners, decide person A and person B. I think you are still waiting for a partner, sir? Or you not got? Rohit is your partner. Go ahead. See, that's why I bring a person along with me. Okay. So here is what the thing that you have to do. So person A and B, I'm going to give you the dream career that you always wanted. Okay? Person A, you are a journalist. Okay? Person B, you are an inventor. You are the inventor. No one can question you on your invention. No one can ask you why, what, and stuff. Okay? So, person B, you have invented goggles for honeybees. Goggles for honeybees. And person A, you are a journalist, not Goswami, but anyone else. You are just interviewing person A to or person B to understand more about the invention that he's made. Go ahead, you have 30 seconds. Quickly start. People sitting, why can I request you to stand? 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back. Stand. We are not going to spare person A also. So person B, so it's a role reversal now. Person B, you are the journalist. And person A, you are the inventor. The rules remain same, right? Person A, you have invented parachute for elephants. And person B, you are interviewing person A. Come on, go ahead, guys. So we see some quotes coming out right now. Four, three, two, one. Come back. Settle down, everyone. Great. The topic that you've selected for today is designing human-centered unicorns, right? So before we start, just a question. All of you know these organizations? Yes? You've used some of their services, if not all? Yes? What is one thing that is common between all of them? Tech firms.
Data. They agree to the consumer data.
Okay, you say consumer need. Someone said data. Someone said tech. Anyone else? Aggregators. Good design. Oh, great. Design thinking session. Good design. Good. Great. So I heard some people saying tech, some people saying, yeah? Interactive. Okay, great. Simplifying our lives. Oh, great. So mythology and philosophy coming together. Oh, great. Yeah.
Sense opportunity. Sense market.
Sense market. Market sense. Okay, great. Yeah.
Everyone is earning good.
Great. Unicorns? Okay, great. Yeah.
They already had a customer base.
They already had a customer base.
All these businesses existed before they existed.
So what did they do different? So
product is being sold.
In fact, they identified a user behavior and they used technology to fulfill that. Great. So what is one thing common? People said technology, but technology in itself is not the real disruptor. The real disruptor is the person who's sitting at the center. Who is the user? People like all of us. Right? We have been using, we had challenges. We had taxis coming in Mumbai, black and yellow. Conditions not good. We never used to feel safe. They used to not talk to us properly. All of that. And Uber figured it out, or Ola figured it out, one of the two. And they said, I can give you a better service. And we said, let's go to those. Similarly, we have others like this. So guys, what is the key message here? It's not about tech. It's about human-centered. It's about being customer-centered, understanding the pulse of the customer and designing for it. You can use any technology for it to help the customers satisfy the need that they are looking at, but it's about human-centered. So before I move forward and we do some good activities here, I'd just like to call someone here. The lady here, can you please come? Yeah. What's your name, ma'am?
Ruchika.
Ruchika. Hey, Ruchika. So, Ruchika, can you just hold your hand like this?
Yeah.
And along with Ruchika, all of us will hold our hands like this. Come on. All of us hold our hands like this. All of you. Okay? Close your eyes. Ruchika, you also close your eyes. Close your eyes. Aankhe band kijiye. Great. Think of something between your hands. Imagine something between your hands. Okay, open your eyes and relax. So Ruchika, what did you imagine?
I imagined a frame.
She imagined a frame.
Yeah.
Let's take some others. What did you imagine, ma'am?
A mobile phone.
A mobile, such big mobile phone? Okay, yeah. Oh. The gentleman there, Ashish, what did you imagine?
Box.
Filled with money? Oh, yeah.
Dollars.
See, Ashish, your box and his dollars combined together, you can take it along. Okay, anyone else who wants, yeah, please? The earth, he wants to own everything. He says, nothing, I want to leave. Crystal ball, you create futures, ma'am. Okay, Dan, good. What if I tell you that you have this baby between your hands? Ruchika, you can take your seat if you want. Yeah. Thank you, Ruchika. First of all, let's give an applause for Ruchika, ma'am. Yes, what if I tell you that you have this baby between your hands? And what if I tell you that this baby is going to die soon? Yes, precisely. There are over 4 million babies that die in India every year because they are premature babies and they cannot sustain the minimum temperature required for a body to live, and they die. So this was the challenge that was given to 7 Stanford graduates to solve, to design an incubator which is $200 and less. Cool. So how would we go about doing it? Let's see, we're all startup guys, right? Some of us are and some of us are aspiring startup guys. How would we go about doing it? The thing that we are trying to address is designing an incubator which is $200 and less. Sorry?
Styrofoam box.
Styrofoam box. Great, good. Start what is required in an incubator. And then what do you do? Then you look at assembling, then you look at how do you make it cheaper, 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 cheaper. Today, just to tell you, today an incubator costs approximately $20,000. One incubator. So we're talking about 200. Yes. Someone else also wanted to take an attempt. Shot at it, yeah? Something portable. Why? You move it around multiple uses. Okay, great. No use of electricity. Why? Okay, great, good. Great.
What are the biggest cost contributors for current incubators, and find out how to reduce this cost?
First of all, we should understand the basic requirement, why we need it at a lower cost, then we approach that market and understand how we can fulfill that.
Great. So I think gentlemen here, one gentleman there, and the lady there. You touched it. Before moving into technology, before moving into dismantling and seeing how can we make it, how can we optimize it, we said, let's take a step back. Let's go and understand where the challenge is. Let's go and understand what the problem, who are facing this problem. Let's go and understand what their life is. Yes? So these guys, they chose this route. They said, we would want to go to the, so this problem pertains in the villages of India, tier 2 towns, that those kind of places. They went to those places and they said, let's go and figure out what the challenge is. Let's go and live their life. Let's understand before we create something. What they figured out was that even if people who can afford it, if they have a premature baby, when these babies are being transported to the towns where these incubators are, they die in transit. So the problem is no more $200. Because if you design something for $200 and you're still installing in the cities, in the hospitals, what will happen? The problem is still there. Because transit will still happen. Children will still die. So what did they do? They said, we need to rethink it. So the problem statement no more was that we are designing an incubator which is $200 or less. The problem statement was what? That is the first thing. So they attempted that. Then what was the problem statement? The first problem is of reach, is of access. Accessibility is the first problem. So we need to design something that can reach here, because we can't change the infrastructure of the whole country at one go. We need to design something that can reach to these places rather than designing something where they need to go in to these places. One. Then they said, like the gentleman said, that then they said that if this has to go to villages, electricity in the villages of India is still a challenge. We don't have 24-hour electricity there. So whatever we design has to run off electricity. Great. So this is how a traditional incubator looks like. This is what they design. So this is the bag where you put the baby. There's a plate to support the bag, and you see this material. This is plastic kind of material here. This is a wax type material that they use, which you, when you, once you warm it, it keeps the baby warm for 3 to 4 hours. This organization, out of the 7 guys, there were 5 Indians. It's an Indian startup based out of Bangalore, known as Embrace. They've already sold over 4 million such warmers from the past 4 years. About human-centered, defining the problem, exploring the problem, identifying who are the people whom is this problem is going to impact, and then understanding what are they facing. It, a lot of times it changes the face or the frame that you look at it from completely. In this case, it went to reach rather than cost. What do you think this costs? We talked about $200, right? We still talk about money. We have to make it affordable. So what did this cost? Less than 100, okay. So he's given a range. Kuch bhi utha lo usme se. Yeah? Anyone else? $100? Okay, he's stuck to a number. Great, good one. Well tried, yes? 1,000 rupees. So it is $25. $25. That's what the cost is. That's what they're selling it at. Think of it. Completely reframing and relooking at the problem. And that's the power of design thinking. It helps you reframe the challenge rather than being product-centric, technology-centric, or being industry-centric. You're being customer-centric. You're being human-centric. I will solve problems for my customers, be those problems in any space that they're looking at. I will expand my horizons rather than making them expand their or contract their ways of dealing with my organization or my startup or my my work that I'm doing. Yes? Please go ahead. Yes, there is. So I can give you, this data available in public domain itself. I can share that with you. Okay, so the key message here, empathy brings in a shift in perspective from designing products, services, or processes to designing human experiences. And that's what we need to start working towards. Be it NGOs like the lady talking about here, they are into designing human experiences. Be it startups, be it established companies like us, we have to start working towards this. Cool. So what are the secret ingredients of design thinking? 4 key things that we need to remember. Empathy, ideation, prototyping, and storytelling. And we're going to learn all of these here right now. We're going to experience and experiment with them right now. So be prepared. You have got some papers and pens? Yes, no, or if you don't, they're going to come to you. People, someone is distributing it. So great, we are going to experiment some bit of it here itself. So cool. Let's get into action, guys. The challenge that we all are trying to solve is how might we redesign an eyewear for our POs. You all understand eyewear? Yes? This is a sad one. You can have a more fancy one that you look at. Okay? We are all going to redesign an eyewear for our POs. Yes? All prepared? Cool. So, all of you have a paper and a pen? We'll wait for 30 more seconds, guys. Let everyone have it. Rohit, you need to be more agile, man. You have less weight and then also you're so slow. Everyone has it? The gentleman there is still waiting. Okay. So the first activity that we all need to do is sketch your ideal eyewear. Go ahead. Sketch your ideal eyewear. Sketch your ideal eyewear. You have a paper, you have a canvas in front of you, you have some writing material. Please sketch an ideal eyewear. There's some people who are still searching for a paper. You need a paper? A pen? I have only one. I can lend you only one. Both? Expectations too high? Hey, you can do it on this also. That's fine. Go back to the problem that we tried to look at. What was the problem? Just read it once again. And I read it to you thrice, huh? Who are you designing it for? POs. Did we even try it? We just talked about it, na? Jinko problem hai, unse poochto lo, jaake ek baar, kya problem hai? Did we even try? No, straight away started sketching. Just because kisne bol diya, to banao. That's what we always do. That is what I want you to change. And that is the key message that you all need to take. One message that if you want to take this. That we need to focus on the human whom we are designing for. Human. That's it. Okay, let's go back. So let's experience empathy first. And then we will look at redoing the same thing. And then let's see how do we change stuff here. Can we have the video, please? question still remains. There were 18 odd people in this entire video, everyone having a different need. Will you give them the same solution or different solutions? A person who's going for the 25th wedding anniversary, a person who's going and visiting her dad for the last time, a person whose tumor is malignant. That's precisely what we're talking about. Feeling what the other person is feeling, feeling their life, trying and living their life to experience what they're going through. Even if we are startups, we don't have money, but you as co-founders can go and see what companies are going through, what your customers are going through, what the humans are going through, and then try and design something. Like the way you feel for them, you'll start feeling for your customers. Great, so we'll continue with the activity that we talked about. So we had person A and person B. You all have your partners, person A or person B, please go ahead with them. Yes, and why are you so sitting like husband and wife, just fought? They come together, please just pick up the bag from here. It doesn't look like they just had a fight and they're separated like this right now, both looking in on opposite directions. Okay, great guys, so now we talked about the whole specs thing or the eyewear thing. Let's continue that, okay? So we're going to design it for peers. Your peer is the person who's your partner, cool? So spend the next 5 minutes, person A, just understand the needs of person B with respect to an eyewear. What does person B go through? What is his life? What is the importance of the eyewear in his life? All of it, just go and understand that. And make notes. Just make notes of what the person is going through, what is the relevance of an eyewear in his life or her life. Please do that. 5 minutes, go ahead. 5 minutes, everyone does it. Anyone who does not will come and dance with me here. I'm a pretty bad dancer, so you have to just accompany me. Your customers also give you limited time. Ma'am, just please be seated only. Just please be seated. Because he's going to be a partner for the rest of the session. Great. So now, guys, let's do a role reversal. Let's do another 5 minutes. You will interview him now. Or the person B is going to interview person A. Same, understanding the needs of person A on with respect to eyewear. Please go ahead. 5 minutes. Continue your discussion. So here I see the gentleman, he's waiting to ask questions and the customer is on phone. All the balcony guys, the premium guys, please continue with the activity. Great. Okay, done. Good. Let's go to the next stage. What you now need to do, you have collected a lot of data. You've collected a lot of information, which was some structured, some unstructured. By the way, I found one need of an eyewear here, a unique one. I saw a gentleman sleeping here, and the reflection of the screen was on the specs, so no one could figure out that he's sleeping. So the person who was sitting next to him, I had to tell him thrice, he's sleeping. Then he figured out he was sleeping. So this in the design world is known as an extreme use of a product that you make, okay, a unique use. Anyways, this also can be a thing. So now the thing that we need to do is, the interviews that you have done together or the understanding that you have gathered together, what you will now do is you will create a common understanding of needs that put together both of you, what are the needs that are coming out? Okay, what are the needs that are coming out? So before we go there, I have a question for you. So you were raising your hand for the question? No? No. I was like, great man, before even I ask the question, he's raising his hand. During my MBA days, we used to call this DACP, Desperate Attempt to Class Participation, and we were like, okay, great. Okay, let's see. So, what are the needs of this lady here? A trolley? Someone said a trolley? Oh, great, good. Or we'll just wait out, guys. We'll ask the premium guys who are sitting in the balcony. They're having all the luxury. Balcony guys, yeah, what are the needs of this lady? Trolley? Okay, so copy paste. Control A, Control C, Control V. Guys, sorry? A laptop. Okay, I sort of love something. Where did you go? A laptop is what she said.
Kindle,
okay. An assistant. Ask her what the problem
An
is.
An assistant.
I'll ask her and I'll tell you what her problem is. Great, okay. Yeah. Okay, anyone else? Yeah, let's take a shot. Yeah.
Knowledge, information.
Okay.
A helping hand.
और हाथ तूने ऊपर किया है. What do you mean by it? Okay.
Glasses.
You need these glasses, the one that you're designing? Okay, done. Barring one person, yeah, please. Gym equipment.
Gym equipment.
The uniquest answer that I've received till now. Gym equipment. Okay, great.
All the books in one day.
So?
She wants some eyeglass where she can read it fast.
Okay, done. Again, going back. Yeah, please. What she is looking for. Basis, whatever is available, what do you think she is looking for? A helping hand is what he said. Okay. So, a lot of you mentioned not the needs. Solutions to those needs. Someone said a helping hand. Someone said gym equipments, body banwa do uski. Right? Someone said trolley. All these are solutions to those needs. What are our needs? Let's go back. Someone said information. That's a need. Kindle is a solution to provide information. Laptop is a solution to provide information. Why am I saying this? If you go back and understand that at the core, why does she need a Kindle? If you say Kindle, or why does she need a laptop? You'll go to the core of it saying that, why, what is she looking for? And then you can have 100 different ways, or you can have the gentleman going to her and just reciting everything, a helping hand. Oh, you're looking at this information? I will read and come to you. I will read and come to you. Okay. So, a Kindle and all whatever you mentioned are solutions to those needs. We need to go to the needs, and that's what you need to look at. One identification thing that you can see is needs are verbs, not nouns. Nouns are solutions to those needs. So go to that level of whatever, if someone has said something, are those solutions or are those wants or needs? Cool, go ahead. Take 5 minutes, make a list of needs. Put together, compile list of needs. Go ahead, 5 minutes. You can discuss together, that's fine. You can work together as a team. Yeah?
Are we assuming that the books are for personal consumption and that she's actually a
there. Rohit? Just come. Gentlemen, there needs a paper. Everyone, stop. Now, the next step to this is something that we are best at, which is what? All of us, right? Without even bloody knowing the problems, we had solutions. So the next thing, I'm going to put you in your strong area, solutions, right? But now the purview of your solutions is different. What you're now looking at is for these needs, how do you need to give a solution together, and not one, you have to at least think of 5 solutions. 5 unique, oh my God, he said. It's already afternoon. Second, it's already, we had a lot of rice and stuff. Sorry? Yes, that's why I said only 5, no? That was episode 25, man. Okay, done. 5. 5 solutions is what you have to think together. So brainstorm and think of 5 solutions to all these needs that we put together. If not all, at least the top 5 needs or top 2-3 needs that you have prioritized. Go ahead. 5 solutions. Light. All these premium guys, we are looking up to you. We are looking, genuinely looking up to you. So you have to be the next, sorry? Get funded. Yes, who's going to fund the gentleman? Okay, so the next thing that you need to do is you need to prototype it. Okay, here what we're going to do is we're going to do sketch prototyping. Okay, out of the 5, You need to choose the top one or two that you have, and you have to create a big idea sketch. You have a big paper? Big idea sketch. Create a sketch. And you're going to give someone a vision? Please create a sketch for that. Beat it now. Okay, so that's the next thing. You need to create a big idea sketch. And while creating a big idea sketch, you also need to compile a compelling story. Story around your design. You need to put up a story. So his customer is already gone. He said he's asking for funding, so I'm not here anymore. Okay. So what you need to do, two things. One, you need to sketch it out. Second, you need to also design a story around your sketch. Because when you need funding, you need a story as well. So two things, put together, total 10 minutes, go ahead. Big idea sketch. Story you want to tell? Done with the sketching? No. Just came. Okay, join them. So you make him do the story now. Cheer, all of you. ये तो वैसे शुरू में जो clapping किया था ना वैसा ही है. It's purely that. It's like. Okay, let's again. If all of you are finished with your story, just give me a cheer.
Yes.
The story is still not complete. There are some who are still doing it. So the gentlemen here are still doing it. Let them do it. And people here also are doing it. देखा जब चेयर में दम नहीं होता ना, जब यहां से नहीं निकलता, तब ऐसा ही होता है. And all the premium guys are just sitting in. Balcony. All the balcony premium guys, right? Premium guys, one of your stories is going to be heard for sure. How many of you would want to tell their stories? One. So there's one founder, co-founder jodi here. No? Acha, alag alag ho. Acha, wo to hai mera, meri to ye hai, sorry. Okay, done. So one, two. Achha, he is not saying me, partner dono, but wo hi bolega. Good. Three, four. Here, all is good. Five. Okay, five. Okay, one by one, you want to come here? No, you did not ask, you did not empathize. Should have asked. Come. Fast. Or you want to tell it from there only, you can tell it from there. So what do you have? Guys, after every story, if we like the story, like investors, we give them a cheer. If we don't like the story, we still give them a cheer, but a silent one more. Okay? Done. Let's go ahead.
Check the house, I will start. And I'm very bad at drawing. So
no disclaimers, guys. Let's go ahead.
There is earphone and just a single frame over here, which is loaded with frame. The story goes like, how did I get my girlfriend back? Because I am an investment analyst and an avid reader. So every time I used to sit in front of computer, so my eyes was always like this. Whenever I used to meet my girlfriend, she used to say, "Tu mere saath mil raha hai ki kisi aur ke bare mein soch raha hai." She rejected. I often got rejected. So suddenly this idea came to me. Why don't I have just a frame which is loaded with lens which reads for me, and the audio would convert it through my earphone. So that's my idea. Good. So this is for reading and this is for watching my screen.
Hey, we do it the young way, we give it a... Okay. We give him a cheer. Woo! Cheer. No, come.
Will you go next?
No. Gentlemen. Yes. Please.
I want to share some real story. अभी मैं
तो उनकी झूठी थी. आपने पहले ही बोल दिया.
आपने visualize किया है और I can.
I had married with that girl.
Yeah. That was a good one.
This one.
That's a good one.
अभी अगर हम सोचते हैं कि ये अगर हम ये चीज़ को हम एक्चुअल में सेल करना चाहते हैं या किसी का सॉल्यूशन लाना चाहते हैं तो आई जस्ट विजिटेड दुबई एंड एटलांटिस. वहाँ पे वाटर पार्क है. वहाँ पे हम लोग जाते हैं तो मैक्सिमम लोग स्पैक्स पहनते हैं. जो लोग को स्पैक्स निकालना पड़ता है फिर पढ़ नहीं पाते हैं, लोकेशंस नहीं मिलता है. तो उसके ऊपर से मैंने कुछ एक डिज़ाइन बनाई है. एक ऐसे हम लोग ग्लास डिज़ाइन करें जिसके अंदर बीच में से छोटा सा एक थ्रेड हो और हम दो ग्लास को आप ऊपर नीचे से थोड़ा प्रेस कर सकते हैं जिसके वजह से आप उसके नंबर्स चेंज कर सकते हैं. और ये वाटरप्रूफ फिल्म होगी, उसके ऊपर बेसिक और एंटी स्टैटिक होगा. कोई भी बंदा इसको पहन के आराम से वाटर पार्क में कोई भी राइड कर सकता है. और थोड़ा सनग्लास इफेक्टिव है जिसके वजह से वो अच्छी तरह से देख सकता है. माने एक तो इको फ्रेंडली, नो टैकी, मैक्सिमम टैकी कुछ इसमें है नहीं, लेकिन मैंने एड ऑन वर्जन 2 भी बना सकता हूँ. पर पहला वर्जन में ऐसा है कि जो किसी को भी अफोर्डेबल हो. सेकेंडली, किसी के भी नंबर्स में चले, यानी हम वॉल्यूम में प्रोडक्शन कर सके. सो दैट इज़ द थिंग. और सेकेंड ऑप्शन में मैं इसमें जस्ट छोटा सा एक सेंसर जैसा लगाना चाहता हूँ जिसके वजह से आप बीच पे बैठे हो और आपको लगे कि मैं कुछ बुक्स यानी डिजिटल बुक्स या कुछ भी पढ़ना चाहते हो, जैसे किंडल है, तो ऑटोमेटिकली आप उसको सेंस करके उसका कलर ब्राइटनेस चेंज हो जाए तो आप सनलाइट में भी पढ़ सके. थैंक यू.
Let's give him a cheer. Yes. Good, good, good. Let's go to the third one. Yes. We'll do this here. You have to come along. वो बेचारा वो आराम से बैठा हुआ, इनसे काम करवाया जा रहा है तुमसे.
ही इज द इन्वेस्टर ना. सो हाय गाइस, आई एम सीमांत एंड दिस इज अनस, माय को-फाउंडर, एंड वी रिप्रेजेंट दृष्टिकोण सॉल्यूशंस. दैट्स आवर स्टार्टअप एंड वी हैव कम अप विद 2 सॉल्यूशंस. फर्स्ट इज एन आई वेयर. सो बेस्ड ऑन आवर पोटेंशियल कस्टमर फीडबैक, वी हैड फ्यू सेट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स विच वेयर ए, the lenses are prone to scratches. B, people lose their specs. C, they wanted multiple features on their specs. So the first specs is, it is made up of light carbon material. It is scratch resistant. It has a Bluetooth enabled headset, so you can kind of take calls on it. And it has also a GPS locator, and it has got wireless charging. So... So that is solution one. Solution two is a gelatin-based contact lens, which the user can wear, and no need to take it off. When you are asleep, it kind of dissolves in your eyes. So all you have to do is wash your eyes and get a new set in the morning. So these are our solutions.
Great, great, good one, good one. Guys, give them a cheer, come on. Yes, let's go to the next one. Okay, that guy has been raising his hands. We'll go to you next, and then the last one, we'll go to the ladies here. Yes.
Ashwardhan, I don't want to design any eyeglasses. I want to design a machine, vending machine, wherein you can go there and do your operations, laser operations in just 10 minutes. And with the cost
vending machine. Yeah. Naam solid hai. Vending machine.
Yeah, yeah. Good. It would be a portable vending machine. The cost would be not more than your eyeglasses. Sorry. Yeah, there are already solutions of lasers treatment in the market, but I wanted to make it in the mass so that it would be cheap.
So aap wahan pe aankh na lo apni.
Yes, yes. That's it.
Sometimes vending machine eats my money. So in this case, the vending machine will eat the eyes.
No, this would be a prototype.
Okay, great, good one, good one. Give me a cheer, man. Come on, go on, a different one. Yes. Let's go to this group first and then we'll come to you. Okay. Go ahead, please. Come.
So how many of you wear lenses here, contact lenses? How many times have you, mostly I'll talk about the women here, how many times have you got drunk and thinking that, oh God, I can't get sloshed and sleep off because I need to take off my lenses? Or stay over at somebody's place?
Solution
sold. Thank you.
Solution sold.
Problem define kar rahe. Thank you. But that's the problem with people who wear lenses. So we are trying to create a lenses which is called Freedom, freedom from carrying storage, like your lens cover, freedom from carrying your glasses after wear, after you take off your lenses, freedom from actually using any kind of solution. So we're looking at making a contact lens which can be actually just wash your face, use water, and you're not bothered ever to carry all these things with you when you have to go for a party or travel or anything else. Also, pollution resistant, allergy resistant, infection resistant. I'll just blink.
That's good. Come on, guys, give them a cheer. Yes, last group. Please. अच्छा एक पॉइंट बोलना भूल गए हो नहीं ओके ठीक है प्लीज गो अहेड
ओके हाय आई एम सोनल एंड आई हैव डिजाइंड ग्लासेस कीपिंग इन माइंड टीनेजर्स एंड यंग एडल्ट्स द रीजन बीइंग बिकॉज एट दैट एज दे कांट बी टू बॉदर्ड अबाउट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ देयर ग्लासेस whether it's sunglasses or otherwise. And hence we are creating glasses, the frames of which are made of silicone and hence durable. They also come with replaceable lenses of different shapes and sizes. So the silicone frame can take in not only different colors, but also different shapes and sizes and colors of lenses. Yeah, that's, I think, pretty much it. Thank you.
Thank you. Give them a cheer, guys. Come on. So, if you look at, let's go back to the question. I told you to design something to start with. You want to say something? No? Okay, done. So, I told you to design something to start with, and you had put something on paper. To what you have designed right now. Someone designed a story of a lady who is married to, right? Okay. So, someone designed a vending machine. Vaco man. I mean... You can just imagine my eyes just going into the vending machine and never coming back only. Okay, so do you think that there's a difference between when you change the lens of looking at the problem, when you looked at it from a human-centered lens, do you see there's a difference in how you look at it? And the solution that you thought? फिर से वैसा ही response है.
Yes.
Done. So that is what the message that I wanted to leave, which is about if you look at your solutions, if you look at your business from a human-centered lens, and you can look at your business, product, services from a human-centered lens, the way you run your businesses, the way you create products, the way you design processes, the way you design services and deliver services will change. And what startups become unicorns? Apart from the valuation part, but what startups become unicorns? The company, the startups, or the companies whose products are loved by their customers. The companies whose products are loved by their customers, ultimately they're going to become startups, they're going to become unicorns. They want to make money. Obviously, everyone wants to make money, right? So, we just finish this. And this was the message that I was talking about. Human remembers businesses that remembers humans. Remember this, guys. Humans who are customers, remember businesses that remember humans. So remember the humans whom you are working for, designing for. And that's what I wanted to share. We also have Sahir with us, who's designed something, who's done some great work in the space of eyewear itself, using design thinking. How has he designed stuff there? He's going to share that story with you. Sahir, please.